In this video, we're going to look at some of the incredible mysteries of climate change. We're going to go back maybe 100,000 years, looking at the changes in climate that have occurred and how little we understand about a lot of those. Now, we're not going to go a ridiculous amount of time back, sort of like when the dinosaurs were around, more like sort of when humans were around. Now, firstly, we're going to look at just going back 1,000 years. So, for example, this graph here shows what's called the medieval warm period. On this graph, zero is birth of Christ up to almost the year 2000, and the temperature along the vertical axis. And you see that around the, you know, roughly around 1000 AD, at least Europe was in a very warm period. This is when the Vikings colonized Greenland, and they called it Greenland, which is a bit strange because it's not very green now. And then it got cooler and cooler into what's called the Little Ice Age. Now, I'm not going to worry about whether we finally got above the temperatures of the medieval warm period. That's a huge debate. What I'm interested in, what was it that caused the cooling into the Little Ice Age? And actually, we don't really know. Now, there is some thought, if you look at the sunspot activity, that there was very little sunspot activity around the 1500s, and that's increased. We don't have any data before that. But actually, the whole thing is something of a mystery. Now let's go back a few more thousand years, say 5,000-6,000 years ago, and Africa, the Sahara Desert. Did you know that in those days, sort of a bit before when the Egyptians or when they were getting going, the Sahara Desert was not a desert. There's lots of rock paintings showing giraffes and hippopotamus in the middle of the desert. Lake Chad, which is, well, still a significantly large lake, was 10 to 15 times bigger 5,000 years ago until just recently. And we don't understand why that change in the climate occurred. It certainly wasn't human-induced carbon dioxide levels, and we think the carbon dioxide levels in that period have more or less stayed the same. So what caused? Why is there this incredible climate mystery? Now let's look at the period over the last few 100,000 years and the massive swings in the climate of the glacial periods. So for example, in this graph here, you can see the present is over here on the right and going back to 400,000 years. And the blue line is the temperature. The red line is the carbon dioxide concentration from ice core data. And you can see that at the present, we're at a relatively warm period and quite stable temperature, but you have these other, what's called interglacials. We have got a rough idea what causes these interglacials, but we don't understand why there was sudden increases and then gentle, slow declines. We don't understand why the present period, the Holocene, is very, very stable. Now, of course, some of you will be saying, well, yes, we do. We've got some idea because these are the Milankovitch cycles. So let's have a look at the Milankovitch cycles. All right, what are the Milankovitch cycles? Well, as the Earth goes around the Sun, it turns out that the orbit of the Earth changes. Sometimes it's a very elliptical orbit, sometimes it's a very circular orbit. And also the tilt of the axis of rotation can change quite a bit. And this makes a huge difference to the amount of sunlight that reaches, especially the higher latitudes. So for example, in this graph here, you can see going from present, which is a zero here, back to 800,000 years, this is the amount of sunlight that's actually reaching a latitude of 65 north. It's about the latitude of Iceland. And you can see there's these quite large changes every 20, 30, 40,000 years from these celestial changes in the orbit and the Earth's rotation. And, you know, we're talking about a 25% change in the amount of sunlight coming in. So this is huge. And this is what's thought, and I think it's right, is what's causing these periods of warmth in the present climate. So these periods of warmth are always associated with a period where there was a lot of sunlight in those northern areas. But there's a problem, isn't there? Because these Milankovitch cycles are nice, smooth, sinusoid waves, and yet the response, the temperature response is certainly nothing like that. And you can get many of these peaks in the sunlight which don't correspond to a peak in the temperature. So we don't understand why some of these peaks in the Milankovitch cycles make the Earth hotter and others of them don't. It's a mystery. Now, coming back to this graph, you might say, well, it's not really a mystery because what's happening here is that the temperature, which is the blue line, goes up and down in a lockstep with the carbon dioxide concentration. So therefore, maybe it's the carbon dioxide concentration that's causing this. But it's not, because actually when you look at this very carefully, it turns out that the temperature is what rises before the carbon dioxide level goes up. So I'm certainly not saying that carbon dioxide isn't having an effect, but it doesn't explain the whole thing. So for example, if you look at the red line here, the carbon dioxide level, it's rising about 18,000 years ago as the temperature rose. And the argument goes that, well, something triggered the temperature rise, which released more carbon dioxide, and that carbon dioxide caused more greenhouse effect, which makes it get warmer, and therefore it released more carbon dioxide. And, well, the problem with that is that why is it that the temperature then suddenly stopped? So if you look at this, the blue line, it gets hotter and hotter and hotter and hotter, and then suddenly it stopped getting hotter. Why did it suddenly stop getting hotter and form this very stable climate of the last 10,000 years? That is a mystery of climate, which we do not understand. And then there's the Dansgaard-Ushka or DO events, where over a very short period of time, there was massive increase and changes in temperature, up to 8 degrees in just 40 years in Greenland. Now, can you imagine if that happened today, 8 degrees in just 40 years? And this brings me to the biggest mystery of climate science, and that is, considering that we don't understand climate on scales of a few hundred years, a thousand years, a few thousand years, or even over 10,000s of years, sure, we've got some ideas, but we don't really understand it. The biggest mystery of climate science then is, why on earth would any scientist make a claim that climate science is settled? Now, this doesn't mean that carbon dioxide doesn't have an effect or anything like that, but it is just a ridiculous statement to say that climate science is settled, or even that the role of carbon dioxide is settled, because as you can see, for the past few hundred thousand years, we don't understand this relationship between carbon dioxide and temperature.
The science of climate change is as settled as the sciences of any other major issue, whether it's medical science, whether it's science we use in engineering to understand how planes fly, how cars work. The science is as settled as it is in any other area.
That, of course, is the line that many of the deniers, and especially in the United States, want you to believe, that the science is not settled, but it is. It's as well settled as, you know, as our knowledge of gravity, or of heliocentrism.
So for me, what this means is that rather than not having so many climate scientists, we actually need more climate scientists, more that are prepared to look a little bit out of the box and not just presume that the only thing that affects the climate is somehow carbon dioxide, because clearly there is a lot going on here, monumental changes which have been occurring over millennia, since forever basically, and we really need to try to understand these properly. So this is basically a shout out. We don't need less climate scientists. We need less climate scientists who are just wedded to the orthodoxy, who won't break out of the consensus. We need them to actually think out of the box.